Do you want to understand how you can control access to your content in Picturepark and be able to set it up or make changes yourself? In this video, I explain the concept of how it works in Picturepark. Control over who can do what on which content is an important functionality of your Picturepark content management system. Let's start with the who part. If you make a list of all the different types of people that need access to your Picturepark, who would be on that list? Starting with people within the different departments of your organization. You may want to think about people working on marketing, product or services, sales, human resources, etc. Next to giving access to all employees if you want that. For people outside of your organization, think of people involved at the creation part of content, photographers, video producers, agencies, designers, partner organizations, suppliers, and sometimes even customers. But also in publishing your content, externals could be involved. Think about giving access to the press, agencies, or freelancers that help you with your website, social media, or other marketing communication activities. Your organization might work with partners, a distribution network, suppliers, and customers that need access to your content. Or that could be university students or others doing research. And this list is far from complete. The do what activities in essence can be split in two groups: view and download content, most commonly that are employees and externals. And the second group of activities is about uploading and editing content, typically done by administrators and editors. The last part is to which content. Here we are looking at groups of content to which access should be restricted. You typically don't want all your users to have access to all content. Under which content, you are defining what these groups of content are and why access should be restricted. We recommend starting from the content lifecycle. When new content is created, it's often not ready yet to be published to its intended audience. A product is not yet launched, or images are uploaded, but the complete metadata hasn't been added yet, are two examples. Let's call this lifecycle phase to check. From there, it goes to public, but most likely due to copyright, legal, geographical, departmental, or other reasons, should some users not have access to specific content. Let's group all those for now under restricted. And when content has reached its end of life, it's archived. There you have it, a typical content lifecycle, from creation over publication to archiving. So, who can do what to which content? If you want to implement this into your Picturepark, the who is managed in the menu on the left under users. The do what can be configured under roles, and the which content is managed under permissions. Let's look at these three concepts a bit more in detail. Under users, you manage the access of individual users to your Picturepark, and you decide what each individual user is allowed to do by assigning one or several roles. Under roles, different user roles are created based on what activities will be allowed in terms of viewing, importing, editing, sharing, etc. The starting list usually includes administrator, editor, employee, and external. Which user roles will be created in your Picturepark depends obviously on what makes sense in your organization. And the different permissions define the level of access to a specific content item. We recommend starting with to check, public, restricted, and archived, from where more permissions can be recreated if required. For each permission, one or several roles can be assigned, effectively controlling the level of access the user role has to and on specific content. Let's take an example for the permission public. All the user roles should have access to content with the public permission. But what they are allowed to do is different. Employees and external users can view and access the original file. Editors are additionally allowed to edit metadata, edit content, which gives them the right to replace the original file, and manage permissions, allowing them to assign a specific permission to content. The only thing administrators can do additionally is delete content. These permissions are assigned to content items, like here an image. If we take this image and follow the arrows backwards, we get the answer to who can do what on this image. This image has the permission public. These four user roles have been assigned to this permission, and you can see in the matrix what they are allowed to do. Then you can look at an individual user and see which user roles have been assigned to control what that individual user is allowed to do on that particular image. Take a moment to let this sink in. You add a user and assign one or more user roles. If needed, are these user roles assigned to the different permissions, defining what that user role is allowed to do, from view up to delete. And the permission is assigned to specific content, effectively controlling the access. Think now also on what are the requirements for your organization. Which user roles and which permissions make sense? Whatever reasons you have, we recommend do not over-design, as it quickly becomes difficult to manage and maintain. Now, there is one more key concept to explain. There are two types of permissions: content and schema permissions. Let me explain why. If we stay with our example image, which has the permission public, and on which the user role editor has the rights to edit metadata, if our editor uploads this image and wants to add a keyword, she can choose from the already available keywords. But if the keyword is not available, she can create a new keyword which is automatically stored in the list keyword. Next time an editor uploads an image and wants to tag it with this particular keyword, it will be available. The same goes for the field products. The editor can choose from the existing list of products, but now it comes. You, as administrator, do not want your editor to create new products. Your product list is very structured with specific product codes, namings and classifications that you want to keep 100% in control. If you allow editors to create new products, it won't last long before that product list becomes a mess. So how do you do that? With what we have learned so far, you can either give or not give edit metadata permission. We call that a content permission. If you have the content permission to edit metadata, you can edit metadata. If you don't have that permission, you can't. To allow this fine-tuning, Picturepark offers schema permissions. A schema stands for a group of fields that can store different types of information. It's a container concept for what you see in the menu, lists, layers, file types, virtual types, and fieldset and relationships. In each one of them, you can add fields in which information can be stored. The ones we use the most are lists and layers. And with schema permissions, you can define permissions for each one of them. Explained in an easy way, you can say that content permissions are about editing metadata, while schema permissions manage access to schemas and their fields on a schema by schema basic. For schema permissions, you have the choice between view, which is by default set to view for all, manage items, allowing a user role with edit metadata content permissions or below to edit, and manage schema, allowing administrators to manage the schema settings like adding fields. Staying with this example, if we give our editor schema permissions on the layer basic information and the list keyword, she can select from the available list keywords and products. She can create a new keyword, but she cannot add a new product because she does not have the schema permission on the list product. That is really a key concept to understand well. Access permission is defined by what the user role can do on the content and by what can be done on the schema. in most cases your layers and lists. This might look a bit complicated at first glance, but it actually gives you as administrator fantastic flexibility to manage permissions adapted to a great number of use cases. We are of course very happy to discuss with you specific needs and how they can be implemented. As there are many roads that lead to Rome, there are often many different ways how a use case can be solved. So, I hope this explanation clarifies how control to content in Picturepark is managed. By looking at three questions: who, meaning your users, can do what, user roles, to which content, permissions, where you need both permissions on the content and permissions on the layers and lists, also called the schemas. And that if you look at one content item in particular, you can see which permission has been applied, which user role has which rights to this permission, and which users have this user role assigned. Answering who can do what to which content. See you in the next video.